Harper Audio presents 10 Things Girls Need Most to Grow Up Strong and Free by Steve Biddulph, read by Damien Warren Smith. A letter from Steve. Dear reader, for 40 years I've worked with parents in groups, and it is so satisfying and so moving that I wanted to share that with everyone in the world. So I set about thinking about how to bring the same experience to you in a book. What you are listening to is the result. You can read it straight through like any other book. But if you wish to go further, there are opportunities to interact using the PDF download included with this audiobook. These are very simple. A self-evaluation quiz, or an idea to give a quick rating to. These instant response items get you personalizing the ideas and applying them to your own life, your family, and especially your daughter. We have field tested these sections and found that parents love the sudden flashes of insight they can bring. And they're fun. You will find yourself seeing more clearly and understanding things that previously had you totally baffled or lost. And from this, you will become more the parent your daughter needs you to be. One more thing. It sometimes happens that the questions can bring tears or other strong emotions, and I hope you will sense on these pages the support and care of others going through the very same things. We have to take care of each other in this journey to make the world better for all our girls. Much love, Steve. You could also use this book as a discussion guide with your friends. Taking one chapter at a time, you can create your own ongoing support group to help you care for all your daughters together. That's how girls were meant to be raised, by a tribe. Foreword. The battle to set girls free. You remember that moment, don't you? Holding your baby daughter in your arms for the very first time, her eyes wide open, gazing back into yours, feeling so protective, so proud, so happy. A daughter! Throughout the last 100 years, things have got better for girls. People fought hard for our daughters to have more equality and opportunity and to be less pushed into narrow boxes of what a girl or woman could be. But about 10 years ago, it's hard to say just when, all this started to change. Girls who had flown up in the sunshine of a century of feminism started to go into a nosedive. Everyone has noticed this. Not just psychologists and counsellors, but parents themselves. They say, 14 is the new 18. Or, they're growing up too fast. Or they just roll their eyes and say, girls. As I am writing this, the Department for Education is reporting that a third of all teenage girls in the UK suffer from depression or anxiety. They are calling it an important and significant trend. The NHS says the same. They report that 20% of girls are self-harming, 3 times as many as 10 years ago. Not only that, 13% of girls have symptoms of post-traumatic stress, something we associate with serious trauma or harm. Eating disorders, body hate, having unhappy and unwanted sex, all are on the increase. It's not all girls, but it's enough of them to worry about. We know the causes of this change in girlhood. It's partly the explosion of social media and the amount of time we spend on screens, but also the pressured and competitive way we live today. The disappearance of spending time with older, wiser, kinder people in the real world, as well as time in nature. Being playful in a relaxed, dreamy way that is best for growing young brains. We know what is needed to help a girl grow up strong and free. And it's not what television, the internet, magazines, or billboards are telling her. It's also not testing in primary school. Nor is it looks, being hot, being cool, pleasing boys, or fitting in to tidy models of corporate success, unless that's really what she wants. So here, from the front line of working with girls and their parents, are the 10 things that girls need most. This book works by building self-awareness, clarity, and purpose, by enlivening your own parenting instincts, by giving you the best information, then letting you choose what to do for your girl and her friends and your nieces, granddaughters, or students. It's a mighty kit bag of tools for liberating your girl. You might even free yourself along the way. After all, we could all do with some liberation. This is an interactive book. So here is your first go. What is your gut reaction right now? 1. Hell no. I don't want to know. Hide me from all this. 2. I'm nervous, but I will read on. I love my daughter and want to help her. 3. I am stirred up already and want to get kicking. Let me loose. Your daughter is unique. There is no one else like her in the whole world. Where is she now? Now you have focused on what your daughter is like and the goals you have for her, we can get started on helping those goals come true. We can find out exactly where she is on the journey. This will help you to know what is needed right now. As parents, we know that our mission is not just about getting kids fed, washed, off to school and having fun on weekends. We also know that it's going somewhere. Every day, little by little, your daughter is moving closer to womanhood. There is a journey that she is on, and you are her guide. So you need to have a map. In my book, Raising Girls, I set out a map of the major stages of girlhood. These stages are now used by thousands of parents around the world. These are simple, and you will recognize them if you think about the girls you know. 0 to 2, 2 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 14, and 14 to 18 are each a distinctive stage based on what is the main thing going on at that age. Of course, they overlap, and the timing varies from child to child, but not a lot. The stages help you to know what to concentrate on, what matters most. In the overwhelming time of parenthood, you can easily lose the wood for the trees, the baby with the bathwater, or the teenager behind the temper. The stages help you to stay on track. Here is each stage with its main lesson. Or put another way, the single most important thing to focus on at her age. 0 to 2, is she loved and secure? 2 to 5, does she feel confident and encouraged to explore the world and enjoy it? 5 to 10, has she got the skills to make friends, have fun, and get along with people in general? 10 to 14. Who is she as a unique person? What are her values and beliefs? And then, from ages 14 to 18, is she prepared and trained practically to enter adult life? The existence of these stages are something parents learn from experience. For example, if a friend asked you to mind their 2-year-old for a day, you could expect a busy time. The day might be fun, but not exactly serene. If a 14-year-old was joining you for dinner, you might expect a certain awkwardness mixed with moments of pure delight. The stages are universal and timeless, and fortunately, we know how to make them go well. If you look at the profile for both of you added together, you might find that you fill in each other's gaps in a very helpful way. Or not. This is the psychology of your family when combining your strengths and weaknesses. It tells you what you have to work on developing. As long as you have a minimum of 6 stars between you on each stage, then you can probably relax about those stages. If one or more stages look a bit wobbly, then this book, as you go through it, will help you with these. Be of good cheer. It's easier to overcome any gaps if you know what they are. In family life, it's the things you don't know about yourselves, the blind spots we all have, that cause the biggest problems. Once you see clearly, you have much more power to make changes. Once you know, you are set to give your daughter what she needs, even if you didn't get it yourself. Lorna, aged 42, says, I was horrified to realise, doing these questions, that my daughter's childhood was a repeat of my own. Too many moves. Men in her life being unreliable, being lonely and on the outside at school. It gave me a massive wake-up call to think, I have to make it different for her. All we do is fight all the time. I am determined to make our lives more positive and calm and steady. I want her life to be better than mine. And Damien, 31. It all came down to stress. We were financially secure, but just too hurried and hassled. In my childhood, we had been poor immigrants, and my parents very busy. But in the here and now, we didn't need to be so wound up. The questions made me see that we had work to do to make life more happy and focused on everyday moments. It didn't have to be the struggle that my childhood was. Now we know exactly where your daughter is. It's time to begin the main part of the book. The 10 things girls need most. 10 things girls need most. Chapter 1. A secure and loving start. It all begins in your arms. Her knowing that she is cherished and safe. But to give her that security, we have to be in the right place ourselves. This chapter is about how to get the most important thing about childhood right. That is, to help your daughter have a deep down feeling of security and worth. Everyone alive needs to have this because it helps us to feel at ease in the world, able to be close to others and able to relax. Babyhood is the best time to get this feeling, but it's never too late to start. For a little child, mum and dad are her whole world. Their emotions are her emotions. A baby doesn't know or care if she lives in a tin shed or a palace, as long as those caring for her are kind and peaceful. If we can manage that, at least some of the time, then long after we are gone, she will carry this memory inside her. When times are hard, it will be there for her to draw on. Of course, this can be hard for us to hear because our adult world is a rushed and stressful place. We might have spent our lives racing to get ahead, but with a baby or toddler, the priorities are changed. The most valuable thing we can do is very little. We need to calm things down. Imagine for a moment what it would feel like to be a small baby with someone's arms holding you gently and a loving face looking down at you. See if you can feel in your body what that would be like and enjoy it for a moment. Imagine knowing that you are at the center of this person's love and concern. Knowing that they will capably and caringly look after you. That you have no need to do anything, prove anything or fear anything. That they delight in you and enjoy you and love you and will give you all that you need, that you are totally safe. Just imagine.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.